So hi everyone and welcome back to another session of PIB 247. I am Manish Mishra and in today's session guys we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are important for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. And remember guys, these sessions are helpful for the ESI current affairs only. For the static part you have to study other things also, alright. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group for updated information regarding the sessions and also regarding the courses. So let's talk about the very first question, which is about the GeMSAHAY app. So the question is, what is the purpose of GeMSAHAY app that has been launched by the Ministry of Commerce and Industry? And here remember, GEM stands for Government E-Marketplace. So an app, GeMSAHAY app, has been launched by the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, and remember, this app has been launched to help medium and small enterprises to avail uncollateralized cash based loan. Jo medium or small enterprises hain unko uncollateralized cash based loan dene ke liye ye app launch kiya gaya hai by the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, which is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal, and he is also the Minister of Railways. Alright, and remember, it is a mobile app, basically has been launched for lending purposes. Okay, ye lending purposes ke liye launch kiya gaya hai, and kiske liye? For the medium and small enterprises. It will help in meeting the working capital needs and ensure the access to finance for medium and small enterprises. Now talking about the beneficiaries, who will be the beneficiaries? So this facility will provide GEM sellers who are the sole proprietors. Jo government marketplace ke sellers hain, jo ki sole proprietors hain, unko is GeMSAHAY app ka benefit milega. They will be provided benefit through this app, which is known as GeMSAHAY app, right? An implementing agency, Government E-Marketplace, and that Government E-Marketplace will collaborate with the Indian Software Product Industry Roundtable, which is nothing but a tech-based think tank. Ye ek tech-based think tank company hai, Indian Software Product Industry Roundtable. Iske saath collaborate karke, Government E-Marketplace will be the implementing agency for this app, for this, ye jo bhi program hai uska, okay? So, isme itna hi padhna hai, that now let's come back to the question, what is the purpose? So, the purpose is, it is a mobile app for lending, alright? So, option A, guys, should be the correct answer, and this lending will be to the medium and small enterprises for availing their, for providing them with the capital, okay? And now let's move ahead to question number 2, which is about ADMM Plus. So, 8th edition of ASEAN Defence Ministers Meeting Plus was held in June 2021. Question is, which of the following is not correct about this platform ADMM Plus? So let's talk about ADMM Plus then. So it was the 8th edition. Remember this, 8th edition of ASEAN Defense Ministers Meeting Plus was held recently and it was hosted by Brunei. Brunei ne isko host kiya tha, because currently Brunei is the chair of ASEAN group. Okay, ASEAN group ka chair kaun hai? Brunei. So obviously ADMM Plus ki jo meeting hai, wo kaun host karega? Brunei. Now, talking about the establishment of ADMM Plus, so guys, it was established in the year 2007. 2007 mein isko established kiya gaya tha, during the second ADMM in Singapore. ADMM means ASEAN Defense Ministers Meeting hui, second edition. Usme ADMM Plus ko adopt kiya gaya, alright. So remember, it was adopted in the year 2007 during the ADMM meeting in Singapore. Now, what is the purpose of this ADMM Plus? So it aims to promote mutual trust and confidence between the defense establishments through greater transparency. Jitne bhi defense establishments hain, jo bhi is group mein hain, uske beech mein aapas mein mutual trust or confidence build karne ke liye, this ADMM Plus was launched, and it is a platform for ASEAN and its 8 dialogue partners. So there are 8 dialogue partners in it along with ASEAN to strengthen security and defense cooperation for peace, stability and development in the region. So along with ASEAN, there are 8 other dialogue partners also in ADMM Plus. And which are these 8 dialogue partners? These are China, India, Japan, New Zealand, Republic of Korea, Russia, USA and Australia. So these are the 8 countries which are the dialogue partners in this ADMM Plus. Okay. Now these are the areas of cooperation, like maritime security is one of the area of cooperations, counter-terrorism, humanitarian assistance and disaster relief. Then we have peacekeeping operations and military medicine. And then we have humanitarian mine action. These area of cooperation, aapko yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai, these need not to be remember. Bas isme aapko itna pata hona chahiye ki okay, these are some of the areas of cooperation, to have a basic idea about the purpose of this ADMM Plus, alright. So this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the incorrect statement. ADMM Plus is a platform for ASEAN and its 10 dialogue partners. No, there are the 8 dialogue partners. 10 नहीं है, 8 dialogue partners है. ADMM Plus was adopted in 2017. No, it was 2007 when it was adopted, which means this statement is also incorrect. There are 7 areas of practical cooperation under this mechanism to be agreed. This is also incorrect, guys, which means all are incorrect should be the correct answer because we have to identify the incorrect statement. All right. And now let's move ahead to question number 3. So an IT-based smart enforcement app for trucks has been launched, which is aimed at reducing transportation and logistic cost of the industry. Question is, which ministry has launched this app? Now remember, in this news, we don't have to go in that much detail that what are the specifications of the app, how will this app work. We don't have to go in that much detail. Okay, just remember that there is an app which is known as smart enforcement app. It has been launched for trucks by the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Now, what is the purpose? It is for implementing of rules and regulations related to road-based violations by the truck. Jo bhi road-based violation truck dwara kiye jate hain, un rules and regulations ko properly implement karane ke liye, this app has been launched by the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. And it is also aimed at reducing transportation and logistic cost of the industry. So that's it. Isse zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Exam point of view se, that is more than enough. All right. So here the correct answer should be what? Option B, Ministry of Commerce and Industry. And don't confuse between the Ministry of Commerce and Industry and Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. Kyunki trucks ki baat hui hai, so you can get confused between the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways and Ministry of Commerce and Industry. So remember, the correct answer here is Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Alright. And now let's move ahead to question number 4, which is about the VIVATech. The question is, what is correct regarding VIVATech, whose 5th edition was held in June 2021? Which means very recently. So let's talk about this VIVATech. It was in news because the Prime Minister of India delivered the keynote address at the VIVATech 2021. Now, what is this VIVATech? So this is basically, guys, one of the largest digital and startup events in Europe, which is held in Paris every year since 2016. 2016 se Paris mein ye har saal hota hai, and it is basically what digital and startup events hote hai, isme bahut sare, all right. And in this event, PM invited the world to invest in India based on the 5 pillars of talent, market, capital, ecosystem and culture of openness. And this event mein kya kya hota hai, which things happen during this event. So it brings together stakeholders in technology innovation, and there are some exhibition, there are some award function, there are some panel discussions, etc. Okay. So this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement. So VIVATech is one of the largest digital and startup events in Europe. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Har saal Paris mein hota hai, 2016 se hota aa raha hai. The event includes exhibition, awards, panel discussion and startup contest. This is also correct. And it is being held in Paris every year since 2016. This is also correct, which means all are correct should be the correct answer, option D, because we have to identify the correct statement. And now let's move ahead to question number 5, which is the last question. Ministry of Port, Shipping and Waterways and Ministry of Culture have signed an MOU for cooperation in the development of National Maritime Heritage Complex. So this is something new which is coming up. So you have to identify where it is coming up, National Maritime Heritage Complex. So remember, this MOU has been signed between these two ministries of Port, Shipping and Waterways and Ministry of Culture. They have signed this MOU for cooperation in the development of National Maritime Heritage Complex, which will come up at Lothal, which is of course in Gujarat. Lothal naam ki jagah hai Gujarat mein, jo ki ek ancient Indus Valley civilization bhi rahi thi. Wahan pe National Maritime Heritage Complex banaya jayega. Now what is the purpose, why it is being made? So it is a first of its kind innovation in the country, which is dedicated to the legacy of maritime heritage of India, and it is basically to showcase India's rich and diverse maritime culture and heritage. India ki jo maritime culture hai, India ka jo maritime heritage hai, usko showcase karne ke liye this National Maritime Heritage Complex will be built at Lothal in Gujarat. Alright. Now this will be an international tourist destination where the maritime heritage of India from ancient to modern times would be showcased, and the Lothal city, which was the ancient Indus Valley civilization city, it will be recreated in this maritime heritage place. And it will be a world-class facility in the vicinity of ASI, site of Lothal. Alright. Now, funding ki baat karo, so the Ministry of Culture will provide rupees 15 crores to develop this area. एंड रिमेंबर इट विल बी बिल्ट इन दी 400 acres ऑफ एरिया, 400 एकड़ के एरिया में इसको बनाया जाएगा. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कल्चर विल रिलीज रुपीज 15 crores फॉर दिस एंड रुपीज 5 crores आउट ऑफ दिस 15 crores 5 crores आर विल बी प्रोवाइडेड ईच ईयर. मतलब 3 साल में 5 करोड़ रुपए दिए जाएंगे. तो इन टोटल इट विल बी हाउ मच 15 crores. राइट. सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई वेयर इट इज बींग बिल्ट. सो इट विल बी बिल्ट गाइज इन लोथल इन गुजरात. ऑप्शन सी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. ओके. So guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching and I hope guys you all have enjoyed and liked this session. Agar aapko session acche lagte hain, to please do share it with your friends and family. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care and God bless.